So after the admission on Sunday, day one, which is Monday, is a day of investigations and evaluation. So the child will be evaluated by various different departments, the occupational therapy department, the psychology department, the physiotherapy department, etc. We also have a whole series of tests, like we do a PET scan of the brain, we do an MRI of the brain, we do EEG, and we also do some blood tests. So Monday, there is a detailed clinical and investigative evaluation. The second day on Tuesday is the actual stem cell day, where the child is called in the morning and is given sedation. So the child is sleeping on the operation table. We then give local anesthesia in the area just above the hip called the pelvis. And then into this bone, we inject the needle and we extract the bone marrow. This whole process takes about 20 minutes. After the process is over, we send the child back to the room. Then over the next 4 to 5 hours, from the bone marrow which we have taken from the child, we separate the stem cells. It's a pure process of purification, filtration and separation. No chemicals or agents or animal proteins are added. We just separate the stem cells gently from the remaining cells. The remaining cells are thrown away, and the pure stem cells, once they are ready, we call the patient back to the operation table, and there a thin needle is inserted into the lower back. This is called a lumbar puncture. We put this needle into the fluid. This fluid is referred to as CSF or cerebrospinal fluid. And we inject the stem cells into the cerebrospinal fluid. Now you may ask, why are we injecting into the cerebrospinal fluid? Because the cerebrospinal fluid, which is in the lower spine, it flows all the way up to the brain. And when it goes to the brain, there the damaged areas sort of pull the stem cells towards them. So we don't have to go into the brain. We want the stem cells to go to the brain, but we don't have to open the skull. Through a small needle in the back, we inject, and then this goes all the way up to the brain. This lumbar puncture procedure also takes about 20 minutes, after which the child goes back to the room and just has to rest in about 2 or 3 hours, can take liquids, water, oral feeds, etc. And only for that evening and night, the child has to rest. From the next day, from Wednesday to Saturday, there is a very intensive process of rehabilitation. We have various aspects of rehabilitation. In autism, these include occupational therapy, it includes sensory integration, a psychological evaluation, ABA, special education, pediatric physiotherapy, art therapy, dance therapy, music therapy, and a whole lot of other therapies which are specially tailor-made for your child and based on the problems and symptoms that he has. And on Saturday, you are discharged, where you are given a detailed note on everything that was done in this 1 week, as well as everything that you need to do for the next 3 to 6 months.